Hi, I'm Dr. Sridhar Kalyanasundaram, consultant neonatologist and pediatrician. We have had a few interesting videos on toddler care. We have discussed discipline, we have discussed safety, we have discussed dental hygiene. We had an interactive session with Dr. Ashok Lodha on screen time. And to follow on this topic, which is very important, I am describing the next two videos on screen time. In this video, we would be discussing mainly the reason why screen time is harmful. And in the next video, we will be discussing about what we can do as parents to minimize the exposure to screen time. So screen time is nothing but the time that we spend watching a screen like television, phones, tablets like iPad and gaming devices as well as the child gets older. So it's a passive process, and obviously there are varying levels of programs intensity. Some are educational, some are entertainment, and some don't have any meaning. So most of the guidelines, including the American Academy, recommend that under 18 to 24 months we should avoid media use, except for maybe brief online video chatting with relatives. For children between 2 to 5 years, limit the screen time to 1 hour a day of high quality programming. And when we say high quality programming, we should make sure that we are sitting and watching with the child, we know what they are watching, and we make it interactive, thought provoking. So we ask them questions on what's happening on the screen. Doesn't need to be science based, it can be entertainment, but you ask them questions like developing morals and understanding interaction. So it should not be a passive process, you should make it an interactive process and some meaning as well. After 5 years or so, obviously in the current environment, the requirement with online learning and things are increasing. So tablets, for example, or computers are part of the school routine, and they need it there for learning, for the projects, and for even for their exams and assessments. So we need to involve them in gadgets, but have a limit and teach them how to use it appropriately. So this is a recap of what we mentioned. So here it says 1 year, but you can read it as 2 years with no screen time. 2 years, around 2 years, less than 1 hour per day of quality programming where you are with the child. It's like reading. So you are with the child, you're interacting, and you select what you want to put, which has some meaning for the child. And 3 to 4 year old, less than 1 hour per day again. And adult supervised screen time, you don't need to sit with them, but you supervise what they are doing. And after 5 years, as I said, it's guided depending on the requirements. However, supervision should be there, and the gaming devices start getting a hold on the child after this. So we should be very careful about what type of games we get. Games which encourage violence should not be bought, and online gaming, gaming with others shouldn't start till their adolescence. So what are the impacts of screen time? So it is well shown that too much or poor quality screen time has been linked to speech delay in the young infants. There is also a concern of autism-like behavior, which we will discuss later. Obesity, because they are passive, not active physically, and actually because they are addicted to the screen time, they don't want to go out and play. Irregular sleep schedules and shorter duration of sleep. Again, they may sit late at night watching a movie or something, and they don't want to sleep on time. Watching screen just before sleep affects the quality of sleep as well. In addition to this, I mean, they also have more behavioral problems, more tantrums, so they may have difficulty making friends. When they actually find the energy to go out and play, they don't interact well with other children, so they may not be part of a team. They may find acceptance difficult, so they come back to their screen. So it's a vicious cycle where they have more screen time, they interact poorly, and so they have less play as well. So this is what we mean by loss of social skills. Again, parents may also find it frustrating that the child does not respond to their calling. They don't learn as quickly as other children. Video games which encourage violence may predispose to violence, and watching violent videos, for example, where hitting someone for slapstick comedy is fun for adults, but children learn from that and they think it's normal to hit others. So aggression may develop as well. Less time for interactive play, as we discussed. In the next few slides, I'll quickly go through some of the important aspects of brain development in brief, which will give you a clear picture of why screen time can damage the developing brain. So the first 2 years is very critical in terms of the speed of development, the areas involved. So the maturation of the sensory pathways like vision and hearing happen quite early in the first year. language development starts from 5 to 6 months and peaks around 9 months to 10 months. So this is acquisition of the skills, and then the expression may follow on in the second year. The higher cognitive function also starts maturing by the end of the first year, and by second year it peaks, and then it's a continuing process all through childhood. So the first 2 years is very critical, and the first 5 years, 90% of the brain physical growth is achieved as well. So you can see that the 25% at time of birth, it reaches 75% of the adult size by 2 years of age. It's a huge increase. And then by 5 years, 90%. And this is reflected here in the interesting sequence on the MRI. So this is the fetus with a very small brain. This is what the birds have, the brain, even when they are born. The mammals, as they develop, the brain size increases, and primates have the biggest brain size, as you can see. So for the human baby, the folding of the brain happens early in gestation, and then it keeps developing. You can see that when the baby comes out premature, the brain is very smooth. It's still having lots of development outside the womb, and so they are at risk of developmental problems. At term baby, the brain is almost fully developed, though the size multiplies by the time of 2 years or so. And then between 2 to 5 years, it almost reaches the adult size, and the Salsegare pattern, the maturation, everything is almost complete in the first 2 to 3 years of age. So this again illustrates how the different parts of the brain develop functionality and activity. And this is very important for you to understand why screen time can be bad. So the newborn brain is pretty simple. It has the brain cells and the axons. The myelination process has not started yet. At 1 month, it's starting to develop the dendritic connections depending on the stimulation, and by 9 months the dendritic connections are quite active, the synapses are being formed. At 2 years, you can see that's a far excess of the synapse, very rapid proliferation of the brain tissue and the connections. And in the adult, you can see that there is a significant reduction in these, but strengthening of the connections that are there. So this process is called pruning. So around 1 year to 2 years of age, the synapse connections multiply rapidly, and then depending on how they are used, depending on what channels are being used, there are channels which become stronger, there are channels which get pruned off. And according to the pruning, the cells which don't get utilized may have programmed cell death, which we call apoptosis as well. So we have the neurogenesis stage, the migration to the top of the brain, synaptogenesis, which we described as the connection formation, and then the neuronal selection and differentiation, myelination, these continue anyway. But it's a pruning stage which is most affected by screen time. So it's a crucial stage between 2 to 5 years of age, and appropriate stimulation, reciprocity where you have interaction and communication are very important for the child to develop normally. There is a relative unpredictability in interpersonal interaction. Suppose the child speaks to one member of the family, depending on their mood, they may react differently. If they go out to play with other children, each child may respond differentially. And so there is variation, and the child thinks about the variation. He tries to adapt his behavior, and this stimulates their learning. So what exactly is wrong with screen time? So it's not three-dimensional. So obviously, the child is passively watching something on the screen. There is no response that is necessary. The child may respond sometimes, singing along with rhymes or making the actions, but that's not a necessary part. There is no response expected from the child. That's why even when you have videos after 2 years, you sit with the child and try to stimulate. Most of the videos are edited. It's a much faster action than real life, especially cartoons. I mean, these are quite bad for the first 2 to 3 years of age because they are fast-paced. They are meant to stimulate laughter, which is not real, really. And it encourages passivity of the child. Again, the risk of obesity as well. They don't understand what is real and what is on the screen. So they are forming their impression of life, and they do have an expectation that the life events will be at the same pace, will be as entertaining, as colorful, as musical as what they see on the screen. So what we call as boredom becomes established at this age, and it's not real term. It's boredom is created by us. We stimulate to a certain level, and then the baseline is set, and if the child doesn't meet that, which is impossible in day-to-day life, that you have your own work to do, you can't entertain the child as an edited video. So again, their boredom leads to more tantrums. So we often see children who have been exposed to excess screen time. They behave like children with pervasive disorders, which are like the autistic spectrum disorders. So they don't interact well, they are withdrawn, they are very silent, they don't react when their parents call out, at least in the beginning, and their language is delayed. They don't respond to our efforts. They also have more tantrums due to this impatience, which I mentioned that the screen time generates. And they prefer stereotypy. They want the same things repeated. So we are confused. Is it autism or is it not? And autism is also a brain development related issue related to the balance of the neurotransmitters. And as I said, screen time can lead to improper synapse formation. Whether this is a permanent change, whether it is reversible is the question, but obviously their behavior like this worries the parents at this age. Maybe it is reversible once you stop the screen time or when they start going out and playing with other kids. Majority of the cases that is the case, but at least in a proportion it does have some impact in the future as well. It's very important to intervene early and intervene aggressively, like total elimination of screen time, and that's what I expect the parents to do as well right from the beginning, as we will discuss in the next video. And it's very important that all caregivers should follow the same approach. So we shouldn't have a mother allowing TV for some time while the father is very strict with it. That confuses, as you can review in the video on discipline as well. So this is just to give you an overview as to in terms of brain development, why screen time is bad. In the next video, we will be discussing tips to minimize screen time. And this is a very important and useful video. I hope you'll share it with your friends, relatives, and colleagues. Thank you.